with, because that was the only West Side stuff. So everyone's like, we always get setup refunds, so we're not going to your weekly, because you don't give setup refunds. And we're like, all right, cool, just won't see you here.
So at some venues, it just doesn't work out. Like, I know a lot of East Side tournaments that give setup refunds, I know a lot that don't. It just depends.
I mean, I've known some that have done, like, the TO just does it out of pocket.
Really?
I know one of the PM guys said he would do it out of pocket today. He just said, like, anyone who brings a PM setup, I will pay your venue fee.
That's pretty
like, that's awesome. But, like, that's also kind of what it ends up being most of the time. Because most of the time, the venue fee doesn't go to the TO. It goes to the venue.
Yeah,
hence,
like,
venue fee.
Like, Briggs or whoever's running the tournament on that day does not make any profit. The venue fee goes to the venue.
Nope, we don't make any money running off of this. All the money from the pot goes to the pot and the players, and then all the money from the venue goes straight to Pete for us using their venue.
Well, as we were rambling on about setups, Peanut and Bully have a pretty decent lead right now.
They're kind of putting the screws to them. This is looking really good.
Morris just misses on teammate, and then a bunch of people have died.
Morris kills his teammate because the missile would have killed him, so he air dodges, and he dies anyway.
I've never thought about how Morris would do in teams. He kind of plays very weird, and like I feel like he doesn't care about his team.
That is entirely accurate. As someone who's teamed with him.
He's kind of gonna do his own thing.
This does, of course, mean, like, if you're a good player, and that's usually who Morse would team with, being entirely honest, he just, like, assumes a certain level of quality, and you can deal with the fact that you're going to be double teamed if you know. He's actually a really good teammate, because he stonk tanks really well, and he actually plays interference really, really well. But I don't think he looks for team play as much.
Yeah,
so
I
like,
can see that.
The kind of stuff you'd expect from like a mid-level player who like plays off of his teammate, you won't get from Morse. But you'll get him breaking up stuff that you wouldn't expect someone else to be able to like save him.
Yeah. I mean, like, Samus doesn't have the greatest tools to set up for like team combos or like.
That's true.
I mean, like, I guess you could, like, get, like, straight hits instead of, like, get a second hit off your teammate or something.
Well, there's that, and, like, Samus' Nair is amazing for counters.
Yeah.
Oh, I wanted the Kaiser. That looked good.
Oh, they're just gonna let Morse be, knowing that they're not gonna be able to edge guard.
I mean, to be fair, it's a fair thing to do because Samus basically gets back from anywhere.
Nick, as he was coming back, Kaiser went up to down air him and he just reversed it. What just happened?
Morse dash attacked him at a very high percent and he died.
Oh, wait, okay. I heard the audio from that and then I saw Nick
go
under an F smash and snap the ledge. And I thought he got hit by it and like something crazy happened.
So Morse can totally do this.
Yeah, one grab.
Peanut has, I think, basically gotten 3-0'd every time against Morse. So, like, the individual is really bad. But, ooh, there we go. Sealing it out.
Morse is crazy against spaces.
Yeah.
I don't get the
number of times I've watched him just half, like, this tiny-ass wave dash back, and you land literally right in front of him, and you just, like, get fucked.
Yeah.
Down smash, goodbye.
He's the crouch cancel down smash master and wave dash back down smash master.
He just knows the spacing really, really well. And he plays kind of a weird style, but it sets up for that spacing game that he plays so hard really, really well.
And Kaiser just gets deleted in 10 seconds.
Yeah, Wooly did really well. That was just beautiful.
Yeah, Wooly's kind of going off right now. Not really getting hit too much, and he's just doing a lot of damage.
I do think Falcon is really good in teams. He's really good at running interference, has really high priority giant hitboxes that just last, like his down air. You just run through people with that.
Yeah, and his lasers are amazing for saving your teammates. Like, I think that's like one of the greatest tools.
Oh, for sure. It does require you to like know what you're doing. Like, I know what Mako said was if you're going to play Falco on teams, you have to be the best player on the TV. You have to be the best player there in order to play Falco really well in a team setup. And like, to some degree, I think he's right. But also, like, Falco has a lot of tools to be able to do some really good things.
Alright, I'm gonna jump back to something, because Kaiser recovered higher to the top platform off stage and somehow Moore shot a missile and just killed him. I don't know what that missile was intended for, but
he just shoots weird missiles out. Like, legitimately, he just does. He's also the kind of person that if he starts feeling like his team's ahead, he will purposely, like, charge up a charge shot and hit his teammate with it. Again, on purpose, just because why not?
I just wonder what goes through this man's head.
Sometimes it feels like not much, and then other times it just, I don't know, I just don't know.
I feel like too much is going on. I think that's the issue. And Peanut still has all four stocks. He's gonna get that. Peanut might not lose the stock.
Watch. Peanut doesn't lose the stock, but Mort, or not Morse, but Wally ends up needing to use him. So he still ends with three stocks.
That'd be unfortunate. That's kind of funny. The Samus down tilt, if it was on some other stage, I think would have killed Fox at like 180. Which I don't think I've ever seen. Oh, wow.
Okay, so he finally dies to Morse's nair that just recovers the jump there.
Yeah, he got a little greedy, wanted to shine spike Morris. I mean, he can be greedy, not by a lot.
Four misses in a row? Sheesh.
I think he told Kaiser to not
let him do this.
Actually, I didn't see if he said anything, but I think that's what he was doing.
I bet you he did.
Ah, changed it.
This is the tether. That's rough. I mean, this is already, only a Peanut are up one already, so it's like kind of unfortunate. They're gonna go back to Dreamland most likely in game three. Hopefully they take one game, but has not been looking good for them.
Oh, wow.
Alright, that was amazing.
I mean, Morse isn't out of this yet. He's gotta take four stocks right now. One of those being at 144%, but no, that's it. Spoke too soon. He didn't get hit for the longest time there. I'm like,
no,
it's
really impressive.
He might be gathering up steam.
So, looks like someone actually popped up in the chat. We got ID Crisis. It's a Michigan player over there on the east side.
He likes to lurk. He's a lurker.
Oh, is he?
Yeah.
Oh, so if you want to get the doubles bracket, you have to do exclamation point doubles, I believe it is.
Doubles. Exclamation point doubles bracket. I think. I don't know. I lurk on the screen too sometimes.
Alright, so it's either doubles or doubles bracket if you want to do that. The just bracket command is for singles, which we have not yet started. We're starting up pretty quickly. Oh, I just got a nod from the TO that sounds like we're starting pretty quick.
I got here. I was flying here because I was running late. But it started at 6:30. It never starts at 6:30. I don't know what I was doing.
We started at 6:30 when I ran it.
Well, I wasn't there for that.
That's actually probably true. So we have Kaiser with his Sheik, which is something admittedly he's been playing a lot. But yeah, for sure. It's pretty good.
I've never played it. But I've seen it do some work. Did it beat Nightmares?
That sounds right, yeah.
Yeah, I feel like I saw that on stream.
We got confirmation from the TO. He's definitely beaten Knight with his Sheik before. I do think that this is like, with the way Morse tends to play, possibly a better setup for your team.
Yeah, it could be. And like, I feel like Sheik is a super good doubles like character.
I think she really is. She's got huge hitboxes, like really long ones, like with that back air. Nair you can sit out in last places.
And Kaiser just needled the charge shot that was about to nail him. So that was pretty crazy.
For sure. Let's be real though. One needle should not kill a charge shot or a missile.
Yeah, the priority.
Samus just gets screwed.
The priority is terrible. And also with Sheik, Kaiser was kind of getting wrecked early on and just like instantly dying. He actually has some survivability now.
Oh, for sure.
He's not just comboing.
Which is one thing you always suffer from as a spacing player, because like you're a fast faller, you're pretty light, so you just sit there waiting to get hit by that next move.
Yeah.
Oh no.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
Well, Kaiser. Kaiser kills himself,
well, probably would have been
after Pina kills his teammate.
Probably would have pretty like easy edge guard too. Remember, if Fox gets lower than the ledge against Sheik, it's a bad time.
It's one of those like if you follow the flow chart, it should be free, but isn't always free.
Yeah, you can get some weird angles and just barely miss the back.
Oh no, he loses another row. Admittedly, that one was like some weird slide off accident, but the last one definitely was just an SD.
Yeah, they had a huge lead, and then something happened.
Two SDs effectively for Kaiser is what happened.
Yeah.
Although Kaiser looks like he may have sealed that stock up. Nope.
Oh wow.
So Peanut accidentally saving both of the other people, and Morse not yet dead due to the giant-ass stage of Dreamland.
This is super close now. This is anyways. Oh? Is Morse gonna try to save his teammate? Oh, I switched to Zelda a little late, I think.
Yeah, you're probably right. So Morse can totally do this, because he gets one down smash clip. Or a good nair on either of these guys, and they should be dead. Especially Wooly.
Uh-oh. Did he use his tether?
He did not. He still got his recovery.
Okay, still has tether. That should be it.
We have influence.
I would have F-smashed and said F you to my partner, but I guess they're playing a little safe.
I don't think either of them have faith in being able to win it 1v1.
Okay, well.
Oh, maybe Peanut. I hope Peanut does.
Is that missile from the ledge?
Yeah. Uh-oh.
That could be it. That is it.
It is. Alright, so that is one game. They are on the board. The problem is they gotta do two more of those without dropping one in order to get through this.
Yep.
Singles bracket is up.
Oh, singles bracket is up.
Now we have Kaiser going Mark, so this is all kinds of interesting.
I guess he's just not feeling Falco right now, so he's doing swank things.
I mean, to be fair, his Falco got, like, I'm not gonna say wrecked, like, he got gimped a bunch.
I mean, I'll say wrecked. I saw some crazy combos on him.
Fair enough. Let's see, you have
I didn't tell anyone I was playing secondaries in the world. My secondaries are still 4C. Yeah, that's pretty much exactly what I thought it was going to be. At least for like a 1-4.
Makes sense. Single mark looking actually pretty slick. I got Rick to start out, so I'll be fun.
Oh, nice.
We always have close sets. Or at least close games, anyway.
Kaiser's actually not doing too bad with this Martha.
Oh, let's go! That was sick!
But he lives!
Oh no!
That was crazy by Peanut.
Morse going for the jab reset. Fair. Oh, and the gimps. And he just didn't want to do it.
Whenever Morse edgeguards, he always just like walks slowly far away to try to like get himself like to where your Firefox has come down, and he just F-smash. Like, that's just, like, how he edgeguards every time. I, like, rarely see him, like, try to do something from ledge. But, I mean, like, with Samus, there's not too much to do, I guess, except for, like, rise
and
air.
He's actually really slick aerial interrupts to get on the ledge already today. Like, just watching the set that he played here. He did one on Dreamland that was, like, beautiful.
Yeah, actually, for some random reason, I slabbed out aerial interrupts with Samus. Like, you can get, like, free ones off of, like, a short hop on stadium and stuff. Like, they're crazy. And they're actually, like, it's a pretty big window when you do it with up air. Like, it's not impossible.
I think when landing on the stage, it's a lot less forgiving than it is going on to a platform.
Yeah, I can definitely agree with that, actually. And he has to drop down to the right height.
Alright, so that's 2-2. They tied it up, they brought it back, despite me not paying much attention to the game. This last one out a little bit. But Kaiser's Marth apparently putting in a decent work. His Sheik was pretty slick too.
I guess that's just what they needed. They needed Kaiser to get to a character that he won't just get destroyed with, and that I
can live a little. Because, yeah. Like, again, if you can't 2v1, or at least hold your own 2v1 against the people you're playing against, teaming with Morse, not really a good idea, in my humble opinion. Because he really leaves you out to dry a lot.
Yeah, he does. He'll just sit in the corner under the platform and just, like, wave dash back. Over and over.
Mewtwo King. He does the same thing Mewtwo King does, where he's just like, I'm gonna sit on the other side of the stage, I'm gonna throw missiles, I'm gonna throw charge shots, you know, instead of Mewtwo King Sheik with just needles all the time.
Yep, exactly. I mean, I'm not trying to take away from Kaiser's secondaries to do some work, actually. Like, oh, man. I thought he was gonna get a camp combo right there, but only have the good DI.
Only knows better.
Yeah.
Didn't have the good side B, but Holy dies anyway.
Pull off in the corner.
He can recover
very
though.
Scary.
That's it. He's living.
Morse's missile is just messing up everything. Some team combos? Oh. Come on, he's even up to.
If you did a short hop, that would have been sick, but the full hop put him too high.
Yeah, it probably wasn't on purpose. Alright.
I think Kaiser thought he was dead, and then Morse got off quick enough to sit and let him live, and then he just gets clipped with the dare, so he dies anyway.
Yeah, that could have been.
Like, this is what I mean. Morse is content being all the way on the other side of the stage, while his partner faces two people. This turned out alright because Wooly decided to approach Morse, and then Morse just gimps him. However, like, it's just gonna happen.
This is a crazy game right now. We got two people with, like, on the lower end of their stocks, and then we just had two people holding four stocks.
Yeah.
Oh, that was amazing.
Just take ledge, roll.
And then they're exactly even now. Peanut's playing with fire right now.
That down tilt actually saving Kaiser, because it didn't actually kill him, and the up smash would have. But he dies there, okay.
Yeah, Kaiser's just been playing near the edge. He's been trying to get, like, back throw games and stuff like that, but he's gotten the grabs and just hasn't been able to capitalize. Wow, he actually, the missile got him stuck in the shine, and then he got neared because of it. Kaiser's just full hopping too much. He's getting caught in the air.
That's something I actually was just getting lectured more or less about from Ginger. I was reviewed. He's one of his mod reviews or whatever.
Oh, okay.
It was just like, you commit too hard, too much, to too many things that are just not good. It's like, even if Kaiser's got the good part about it better, so he's like, he's making the commits, he's making too much of a commitment, and especially in doubles where you're playing against two spaces who are way faster than you are, in the air at least. Mm-hmm. You can just